So good morning, everyone. So I'm here to present a topic on this detecting structural and functional glaucoma progression. As you all know, that glaucoma is a silent killer of vision. So it is very important to monitor the progression of the disease in early stages so that the patient doesn't develop blindness. So as you can see from this, the structural changes, they occur much more before than the functional changes. So it is very important to detect the progression at this stage, because the functional, before the functional changes have developed. So coming to the advantage of the OCT, it is very fast and objective. It is highly reproducible with low test retest variability. It is able to evaluate the RNFL, macular thickness and ONA changes at the same time. Structural progression precedes the functional progression in early, and it can detect progression even in the pre-pymatic stage. Hello, can you hear me, sir?
Yes, we can hear you, and we can see it also. You can continue.
Okay.
We can see the advantage of OCT.
Yeah. Right. So now, what are the what is the best structure to measure? So before going into the scans, we should know some of the important things, like which is the best structure of the retina to measure. So what quantity of change is significant, and are the structural changes relevant to the patient in terms of glaucoma progression? Are the longitudinal measurements affected by aging, and how can the changes resulting from aging be differentiated from true progression? And what are the best ways to use the OCT alongside visual fields? Now coming to the best structure to measure, I think the retinal nerve fiber layer has been documented as to be the best structure for measurement of glaucoma progression. And OCT devices now also have the ability to quantify changes to the glaucomatous macula using the ganglion cell IPL and the ganglion cell complex. Coming to the RNFL thickness, to assess the progression, some things have to be kept in mind, like the floor effect, whether the thinning is suggestive of glaucoma progression or not, whether the thinning is due to normal aging, and the correlation of the RNFL loss on the OCT scan with corresponding visual loss. So the OCT machines, the analysis of progression is done either by the event or trend-based methods. In the event-based analysis, it measures the difference between the baseline and the follow-up measurement. So any decrease in 5 micron is suspicious, and any decrease in 7 to 8 micron of the RNFL thickness in a given sector, it suggests progression. Coming to the trend-based analysis, as you can see in this graph, this black points, these are actually the thickness which have been mapped at various periods of time, and this green one shows the normal RNFL with aging, and this slope, it shows the negative slope. So a statistical difference of less than, or the significance of less than 0.05, is defined as progression in trend-based analysis. Now the macular scan, it has also some role, because the highest concentration of retinal ganglion cells are in the macula. So they can contribute towards the glaucoma diagnosis, and the GCL and IPL measurements have excellent long-term inter-visit reproducibility. Also in advanced glaucoma, when the floor effects of the RNFL sets in, the ganglion cell and the IPL thickness, it remains above. And so this is during and for advanced glaucoma. So these parameters are taken into consideration. So this is a ganglion analysis cell map. So these are showing, like the blue color, it is in normal range. The warmer colors are normal thickness, and when we go down to the deep colors, this actually shows thickness, thinness of the, or loss of the ganglion cell complex. Now combined RNFL and macular scans have shown clinical indicating early glaucoma, because the RNFL thickness changes are more readily detected due to the faster rate of RNFL loss. But in advanced glaucoma, when it reaches the floor effect, OCT can be more useful. And also in some patients with myopia, we have variability in dysmorphology. The optic nerve head scan has not been widely accepted, probably due to variability, disc size, tilt, torsion, and peripapillary atrophy. But some current OCT machines, what they take into account is the Brooks membrane opening area and the minimum width area as the anatomic point of reference. So how early can we demonstrate progression in an OCT? So this is a graph which has shown a patient having a 95 percentile of RNFL thickness, and this is the 5th percentile. So a significant amount of, like 1/3 of the retinal ganglion cell loss has already occurred before any detectable changes, even in the normal OCT, because if it is in the green zone, the OCT will term it as normal. And only when it comes to the yellow zone or the red zone, it will be outside normal limit or borderline. So again, this is the graph which shows like progression in green, means we can detect the, see, this is the borderline. So if even before reaching the borderline, we can detect the progression by serial OCT scans. So this is a GPA analysis or the Cirrus HD OCT machine. I just like to read out the printout once. So number one is like it has shown the patient data and everything. Number two is like the baseline. This is the average thickness of the RNFL. This is the baseline. And number three, it shows any deviation from the baseline. The orange color, it shows possible losses, and the red colors itself shows likely losses. So this is a train-based, and this is an event-based, and this is a train-based analysis of the average RNFL thickness. These points are actually taken over a period of time. These are measurements of the RNFL thickness of the average RNFL thickness. And if you have this black dots, which are normal. If it is red or orange, which shows likely or possible losses. Same, this is the superior RNFL thickness train-based analysis. This is the average cup to disc ratio, and this is the inferior RNFL thickness, which is against. But this is the train-based analysis. So these are the measurements from which the graphs have been plotted. So we have to see whether this red zone, they show likely loss, and this orange zone, they show possible losses of the RNFL. So this is a ganglion cell. So same as this is the GPA analysis of the ganglion cell, which is again showing this is the baseline measurements. And this colors, they are showing this is the orange color, they are showing likely loss, and the red color, they are possible loss, likely loss, and the orange, they are showing possible losses. These are actually any deviation from the normal baseline measurements. Similarly, we have the average GCL and IPL thickness. This is the superior and this is the inferior one. This is again the this is the data. This is the cumulative data which have helped us in plotting the graphs. So these are some of the tables and some of the studies which have been done. So in all the studies, they have shown early progression on OCT leads to visual field changes also, because eyes progression of VF has greater rates of macular thickness loss. There are many studies which I have written here. Now the next important thing are the structural changes relevant to the patient. So the studies done by Mickey et al. And New et al. Have found, like, if there is a particular value, if there is a loss, it corresponds to higher risk of visual field in developing glaucoma. Now combining structure and function in glaucoma, structural changes observed in glaucoma are commonly accompanied by functional loss, which may ultimately result in significant reduction. So standard automated perimeter remains the established approach for monitoring functional glaucoma loss. So the question is, how much damage needs to be happen before detection is clinically possible? Again, we can see this is done by a spectralis OCT machine. This is a train-based analysis. So what they have done is, over a period of time, they have taken the measurements of the RNFL thickness at various times, the various ages, and the legend here given is whether it is significant or not. So any downslope or negative slope, same thing, we can see there are changes out here also. So nowadays, there are available OCT systems for structure and function evaluation. This is known as the forum. This is which can automatically combine relevant information from both the Humphrey visual field, the Cirrus HD OCT, and the fundus images. And the HFI and the Cirrus OCT combined report on the forum, it summarizes the patient structure and function analysis on a single printout. So what is important about this printout is it is a single printout. It is not comparable with any normative data. It has been taken over a period of time. So this is the gray. This is the Humphrey's visual field. As you can see, there are some visual field defects. Same thing on the OCT. Also, the RNFL thickness has shown here. So this is known as a flip comparison, structure and functional comparison together. The red areas, they show outside borderline or severe thinning, and the green and yellow is the borderline, and the green is normal. This is the same thing which we can see there are in the left eye, there are two areas which have shown outside the normal limit, and this is a yellow zone which has shown borderline. This is a forum workout of the spectralis OCT along with the Heidelberg H perimeter. Here you can see the patient has defect in the inferior nasal in the quadrant, and in the OCT it has shown the superotemporal quadrant, which has been flagged in yellow. So this has shown thinning. So this is actually a swept source OCT done by a Topcon machine, and it takes into account everything, like the circumpapillary RNFL thickness. This is the OCT machine, and this is the thickness which you can see this line, which is sometimes has gone beyond the normal range also. And this is the RNFL thickness view, and this is the GCL and the IPL thickness view. And this is the propagation plot, actually. So this is the propagation plot. And from here, we can see the changes which have occurred and the progression which is likely to occur in a patient of glaucoma. So to conclude, since the introduction of OCT, more than 25 years ago, our ability to detect and quantify glaucoma has been greatly enhanced. Although visual function is more important to the patients, progressive structural changes can precede functional loss, and patients with faster changes on OCT are definitely at an increased risk of worsening visual loss, offering the possibility to escalate treatment at the earliest stage of presentation. Thank you so much.
Sorry to interrupt, sir, but the time is up.
Yeah, I'm just going.